the learning should never stop. And I'm super, super excited too, because today, what you're going to learn today, you won't find it anywhere. So, number one, if you're ready with the notepad and the pen, and if you're ready to take on the digital world, type on the chat box, I am ready. Type on the chat box that I am ready, right? Because I am also ready over here with my notes, my sessions, and most importantly, the kind of learning which you're going to get over here is going to be super exciting for you guys. Okay, now, just to give you a perspective, just give me a moment. Let me get my slides up. So just for information, this session today will be a 3-day long session, right? Today we're going to start off with fundamental of digital marketing. Why? Because with fundamentals of digital, you'll be able to get a basic block of digital marketing over here. Okay. Number two. Okay. Tomorrow we're going to see about affiliate marketing. We're going to see about influencer marketing. So how many guys over here are excited to become influencers and affiliate? Give me a quick eye on the chat box. In case you want to become an influencer, you want to become an affiliate, give me a quick eye on the chat box. Okay, fantastic. Let me begin. Let me just share my screen. So first of all, welcome to this particular session of 3-day digital marketing seminar for students, professionals, and everybody who's coming over here from different parts of the country. Before I begin, I want to understand that where you guys are from. So if you can just quickly put in the chat box that I am from Mumbai, Delhi, Bangalore, Chennai, Canada, US, where you're from. So I know that most of you have come from different parts of the country. And also some people have come from international places as well. Like we can see people from UAE, people from Canada, people from India, people from, you know, Mysore, Coimbatore, Dubai. I can see a lot of people. Fantastic. I can see hundreds and hundreds. Okay, cool. Pretty cool. Now, one request to people who are watching this session on YouTube currently, you will see a small cross button. My request is to please click on the cross button. Right. In case you don't want to see the chats, because that way you can learn interruption free. All right. So let's begin. And also, this is an official attempt for Guinness Book of World Record for the largest digital marketing session taken on the internet. Right. Because if you see today, you know, you all are a part of one of the biggest digital concerts. Like, for example, you must have seen YouTube fan fests. You must have seen people coming live over there. But today, have you ever seen 20,000 plus people coming live and attending the session over here? Give me a quick yes or a no, right? Then how many guys over here would want to be a part of the record? Type the word I want to on the chat box. Type the word I want to on the chat box, right? Because, and it's all possible because of your support, right? Without you guys, nothing would have been possible, right? Okay. Number two. Let me just introduce you first of all what Nostrum Academy is all about. So Nostrum Academy is the brainchild of three people. Our first founder is Neil Dodia, all right, who basically works behind the scene, is an expert in social media. Second is me, Hitesh Motwani. And third is Roshni, whom you just met some time well back, right? And in case you want, I would request you to basically, you know, just subscribe to our channels on Instagram, YouTube, Telegram, and, you know, on Facebook group as well. On Facebook, you can just type All Things Digital by NSA. You can, on Instagram, you type the Nostrum Academy, same on YouTube and same on Telegram. Just search for us, you'll be able to find us and subscribe to the channel, because that is how you'll be updated about every time new things coming in over here. All right. And this learning starts today for the next 3 days. So let me just give you the agenda for 3 days over here. Today, we're going to start looking at fundamentals of digital marketing. That is, how do you start doing digital from scratch, step by step, so you can start beginning your digital marketing journey. Now, I want to understand over here, who are these guys who are doing digital marketing for the first time? That means you never, ever thought about digital. You're doing digital marketing for the first time. Type the word one on chat box in case you are coming digital marketing for the first time over here, right? Because it's very, very important that we understand the crowd so that I can accordingly tailor make my content for you guys. It will be impossible for me to look at chats and answer your questions. So what we have done is towards the end of the session, we're going to have question answers kept by you, and I will answer all the questions. Now, second thing, okay, today we're going to start with basics. Tomorrow, we're going to see how do we do influencer marketing and affiliate marketing. That means, how can you start becoming an influencer? How can you start impacting the world? What can you do about it, right? And most importantly, how can you make money from digital? How many guys over here are interested in making more money online? Type the word I on the chat box in case you're interested in, you know, making more money over here, right? So we're going to show you that, how do we do that. But let me tell you, it's not like a get rich quick scheme. Okay. This basically is purely with hard work, dedication. It's not easy, but it's not difficult as well. All right. Just a situation of caveat over here. And number three, on the day number three, especially for students, first time job seekers who are here today, you know, I'm going to show you how can you make resumes? How can you do a digital job search? That means you can find any job on this planet with your digital marketing skills. All right. So we're going to tell you how do we do that as well. Do you think the day three lineup is super? Just type the word super on the chat box. It's a super lineup for day 3 days. Right. And that's what the magic is, my friends. The magic over here is that how can we take you from level zero to level five? Right. And what I would recommend you is, in case you're on this page right now for a while, click a photograph of this page, keep it with you and share it on your social media handle. So that many of your friends would come to know about day two and day three. And if possible, even about day one right now. Let's begin. All right. So first of all, let me welcome you to the day number one. And today we're going to see how do you start your digital marketing journey from scratch, from step-by-step approach without any fluff. Okay. So first of all, thank you so much, you know, because without you, this all would have not been possible. I'd also like to make a special note to all the teachers who have been helping us to spread the word around. Okay. And we've got such a huge turnout. You know, what's the best part about this? We have spent 0 rupees today on getting such a huge crowd. And it's just because of your love and your dedication to learn. Okay, now let's begin. So let me first of all, can I take about 2 minutes to just introduce about myself and for you to just understand that where do I come from? It's very important for you to understand who I am because you're going to stay with me for next 2 days. And day number three, my colleague Neil will take over. In case you want to know who I am, just type the word, tell me on the chat box and I'll just share with you a bit about my background. So currently, okay, I am Hitesh Motwani. For people who do not know me, I'm a director at this company called Nordstrom Academy, where basically I take care of making curriculums, making portions for all of you, and also handling the digital marketing services over here. I also have one more company called Skillopedia. At Skillopedia, we do consulting businesses for various firms. In the past, I used to work at this company called Ogilvy, and over there, I handled Twitter in India. So I was a part of the launch team of Twitter in India, and we worked with Twitter a lot in terms of doing the brand building in the country. Not only that, I've also got a privilege to work with Mr. Ratan Tata and the Tata Groups and the Tata Sons to handle their digital marketing. Till date, you know, I have trained over 20,000 plus participants, and this has taken me 10 plus years. But you know what's the beautiful part about today's day? The beautiful part about today's day is that in one day, this number is going to double up. And I'm going to write on my CV from next time I attend 40,000 plus people. And that is the power of digital marketing. You know, in case you want to understand the power of digital marketing, this is it, guys. Look at all of you in this room right now, because without you, you are digital. Without you, all these things wouldn't have been possible. And till date, we've trained over 400 plus corporates helping them with digital marketing. But you know what? Today, I'm not here to tell you about my success. I'm going to tell you about my failures. In the past, was never fortunate enough to have all of these lifestyle with me. I come from a very humble background. How many students over here, you know, you have this passion to do something in life, but your parents, unfortunately, don't agree with you that you want to do this. How many guys over here have faced this situation? Type the word I on the chat box in case you faced a situation in the past for you. Type the word I on the chat box. Give me 1 second, guys. Type the word I on the chat box in case you have faced a situation in the past, right? So just like you guys, you know, so I wanted to become a DJ when I was young, all right? But my typical parents, I come from a Sindhi family, typical parents told me that, you know what, Hitesh, DJing and all, koi gana wana bajaye kamata nahi. You can't make money by just singing, you know, by playing songs. If you want to do something, get a better job. So I started first in the banking industry. I used to work in a bank, but the banking industry, I didn't enjoy wearing tie and being too formal out there. That is when I started investing in myself, and that is where I started fulfilling my dream of digital marketing. But for the last 8 years, I've been working in corporates, and you know, I was not getting enough fulfillment. And when I started my business, that is where I realized the real worth of teaching. You know why? Because when you start doing the business, you understand failures and success in life. How many guys over here agree that, you know, business is not easy? Entrepreneurship is a very tough game. It means when you start going to your best friends and telling about a business venture, half of them will say, no, just stupid idea. How many of you guys have faces over here? Type the word me on the chat box. You get your faces over here. I also face this thing every single day. But the only one that can win is just somebody who does not really give up. And in the last 3 years, I've only done one thing and one thing in life. That's marketing myself. There's only one skill that can really change your life. You know what the skill is, my friends? It's marketing. So you need to start marketing yourself, because when you do not market yourself, you're making one of the biggest mistakes. And that's what is, my friend. In the last 3 years, we've been running a lot of campaigns, a lot of ads, and we've trained corporates like Glenmark, McDonald's, CNBC, etc. Not only that, I'm a non-IIM, a non-IIT, but today I train at IIM Bangalore. We've trained a lot of corporates. We did a lot of workshops in India, Singapore, and Dubai. And most importantly, we've trained over 20,000 plus people, 400 plus corporates, 100 plus startups, and I'm also a mentor with Facebook. But I'm going to show you exactly what mistakes I made in my life and what mistake you should not make in your life so that you start your digital marketing journey smoothly. You know why? Because nobody was there to guide me. Nobody was there to mentor me. But today, if you help me give an opportunity to you, I can guarantee you that this session will change your life the way you see digital marketing. So today we're living in a very interesting time. You know why? Because today's generation, today's babies, they do not know how to speak, but they exactly know how to use internet. Do you agree with me? Type the word agree on the chat box if you agree with me. So today's baby do not know how to speak, but they exactly know how to use internet. And today machines are learning, but human beings are hooked onto the cell phones. And that is the power of digital. You know why? Because anybody with a cell phone, you can reach out to them and tell them about your venture, tell them about your business. If you see, you know, the way generation has gone, people in 2000, when there was a concert, people should just listen to the concert, enjoy it out there. But today, that's not the case. Today, we record everything. So even if you are not there online, there are still people recording you. There are still people talking about you online. But currently, in the situation that we are in right now, everything is becoming online. And if you do not go online right now, you're missing one of the biggest bus. And how many of you guys over here realize that today, if you're not going online, your business in future, your career in future won't survive? Give me a quick yes on the chat box in case you agree with me. If you look at this last week itself, 2 weeks back, I think, when there's a Janta curfew, Sonu Nigam, right? He basically had hosted an online concert and he got close to 1.6 million views live over there itself. And that's what really the thing is, my friends, you know. You see, the world is changing, right? The question is, are you? So today, how many guys over here are committed to change? You know, there are two kinds of people who come to my session. The one kind of people who just come, attend, and go. The second kind of people who come, who take the learnings, take the action, and they actually implement things. So how many of you guys over here are ready to implement things for yourself? Type the word action on the chat box in case you will be an action taker. Because I want all of you to be an action taker. Because if you don't change now, the times will change you, right? And that's what really the most important thing is. I want all of you to become an action taker right now. Okay? Fantastic. All right, let's move forward. So if you see, the world today is not divided between AD and BC. It's divided in two parts, life before mobile, life after mobile. How many of you guys over here, you think your life is currently dependent on this small device that you hold in your hand? And the day you do not get this device, you know, you will probably have a mini heart attack. Type the word I. If you don't get the device, you'll probably get a mini heart attack right now, right? So if you see, our life is dependent on this small device, right? And I'm going to tell you a couple of things, just a fun thing to do. And if you relate to any one of this, I want you to type on the chat box, I do, all right? So today, if you see, the way we watch television has changed. Nobody thought that Netflix and YouTube will take over. How many guys over here have television sets at your home, but currently you just watch content on Netflix and YouTube? You don't watch TV for cable, like what I do on the chat box. If you see, earlier you used to wait one week for the episodes to come, but currently we wait for 1 year to get the next season out. Type the word I do on the chat box in case you agree with this as well. That today we are so hooked on to this that we actually want to, you know, get seasons after seasons. We don't mind doing a lot of binge watching, right? If you see in the earlier days, we used to remember a lot of phone numbers, right? But today we don't remember our own number. How many guys over here do not remember your own number, right? But you remember, you basically, you know, old phone numbers out here. And most importantly, today people don't even talk to each other. Today people are more comfortable chatting. Is anybody over here is more comfortable chatting as compared to, you know, speaking over the phone? That's what I do on the chat box, right? And if you see, forget anything else, the way we used to read books, like earlier I remember people used to Xerox, but now people click photographs on cell phones and they keep it by themselves. Today people read ebook, people read Audible. How many guys over here are a big fan of Audible and ebooks? That means you've ditched physical books, but you read everything on a Kindle device or an Audible, right? And forget anything else. You know, if you remember in the olden days, we used to actually get people, we used to get songs from people via this thing called as Bluetooth. But currently, we don't even need that because all we do is we just stream songs and we keep our playlists on the cloud. We do not keep it on the phone, right? And if you see, the travel industry has changed because traveling is no longer about calling up the travel agent and telling them, hey, you know what, book my ticket. It's all about make my trip, yatra, and Bollywood overtaking the world, right? Banking has changed. I don't even remember last time when did I go to my physical bank because everything is happening online. And forget anything else. The education system that we are currently in, even that has basically changed. If you agree to all of this, type the word I agree on the chat box. If everything is changing, my friends, why aren't you, right? Which is why, if you see, you don't realize it, but you are currently a part of a digital revolution. You've already come in this thing called the digital age. Because at this age, what we simply do is we are hell-bent and addicted to our digital devices, which is why you don't have an option, but you need to go digital, whether you like it or you don't like it. You know, if you really ask me today, all of the people present over here, about 25,000 plus people present over here, you're currently only in one business, my friends. You're in one business that's only marketing yourself. Because if you do not market yourself, if you do not really go out to people and tell people what is so good about you, how will people come to know? For example, if you think that, you know, I can't market myself, let me tell you, we all are born marketeers. Let's take, for example, when you were a small kid and you told your father, if I get 80% in my exam, will you basically give me a bike? Will you give me a PS? Will you give me a PlayStation? Will you give me a toy? Right? That's what? That's basically marketing. Forget anything else. When you go for your first internship or job interview, what do? You tell the interviewer that, hey, you know what? If you're going to hire somebody, that's only me. That's nobody else. What is that? That's also marketing. Right? So you are only in one business, that's marketing yourself. If you do not market yourself, somebody else will market himself and take your job, take your career, take your position away. Do you agree with me? Type the word agree on the chat box. And most importantly, I want you to become one of the world's best marketer, because that's my mission, guys. You know what's my mission at doing this session is to make world's best marketer. And I want to make at least 1 lakh marketers in the next 1 year. And that's why I'm over here today, standing in front of you to do this session in front of you right now. Let me also tell you that, you know, if you think that I'm the best in my craft, I'm the best in my job, best in my responsibility, the best person does not win. The best known person always wins. Let's take, for example, there's a kid who is a bit naughty, but very smart, very outspoken, and he actually helps everybody. This other guy who's also smart, very outspoken, does not showcase his talent, does not showcase his skill set. Who do you think takes a job away, or who do you think takes a career away? The guy who speaks and who interacts and networks with people, or the guy who just sits in a corner but still intelligent? The first one or second one? It is the guy who actually goes out there and markets himself. So remember, people, the best person does not win. The best known person always wins. So I want you to only remember one thing in life, that from today onwards, you will only and only become the best known. You will not become the best but the best known. Can I have a commitment from all of you that you will become the best known? Type the word best known on the chat box. I'll take a moment out here because I want to just see how many best knowns we have got. Because that's what I want. I want everyone to become the best known. That's fantastic. I see a lot of best knowns out here. All right, so let's move forward then. Now let's understand, let's get to the business of what is digital marketing. So digital marketing is basically what always everybody says is to basically promote your product, service, or you know, or your brand on a digital device. But this is what you hear in every textbook, PowerPoint or slide. What actually digital marketing is? In reality, digital marketing is one of the biggest shift in the country. For example, if you look at your father and forefathers, you know, when they started doing marketing, when they started doing a job, they were actually working currently, you know, for big manufacturing companies, big corporates, okay, and basically they were working in a lot of manufacturing units. That was the Industrial Revolution, right? Then came a time where today all of us currently, we want to work for MNCs, global brands coming to India and we going abroad. How many guys over here are, you know, you dream and aspire to work with a global brand? Type the word me on the chat box. In case you do that currently. In case you aspire and you basically want to work with a global brand right now. Okay. So that's the era of globalization, you know, where international companies started coming to India, like Starbucks, you know, Ben & Jerry's, your Louis Vuitton all came to India and we started going international as well. But the third biggest change that has happened today is what I call as a digital revolution, right? Because digital revolution is something that is basically changing the world because everybody today over here is only in one thing, that's digital marketing. Do you agree with me that without digital, nothing can really happen? Why? Because today digital is nothing but it's a lifestyle. Okay, it is a way that we live. In fact, when you wake up in the morning, 90% of people do not go for a toothbrush. They only go for a phone. How many guys over here do that? You actually go for your phone rather than go for a toothbrush. That's the first thing you check in the morning is your phone. And before you go to sleep, the first thing you check is your phone. Right? Give me a quick eye on the chat box. Which is why, you know, there are about 7 billion people on this planet, but 5.1 billion people own a cell phone. Only 4.2 billion people own a toothbrush. If you see the largest country in the world is not India, China, or US, it's Facebook. Facebook has got about 2.3 billion people currently worldwide. Not only that, today digital marketing is like an oxygen that no business can survive without it. And how can digital marketing help you? Let's understand that. Digital marketing helps you in three things. Number one, it can help you to become an influencer, right? How many guys over here, you dream to become an influencer? That means you want brands to come to you. You know, you want to basically stay in the best of places when somebody else pays for you because you have got a huge crowd. You've got a huge fan following. Type the word I on the chat box. In case you want to be an influencer, my request is to come again tomorrow because tomorrow we have a session on influencer marketing at 5 o'clock. Second thing, help you become famous. So let's take, you want to sell a particular product. Like look at this lady, you know, who was there in the one of the singing shows, right? She was actually going and singing on roads. Somebody just captured her video and today she's singing with Himesh Reshammiya, correct? It can help you to become famous. So in case you want to become famous, you want to become a brand, you want to basically start promoting your own selves, you can do that. And that is what digital marketing is all about. It's given one of the biggest level playing field. And number three, it can get you better traffic and most importantly, get you a better job as well. And we'll show you a lot of examples on how can you get a job as well. Now, why digital marketing is such a big deal is because digital marketing is cheap. That's the first reason. That means you can start doing digital marketing just 100 rupees per day, right? And not more. Number two, it's precise targeting. I can actually target those people whom I want to reach out to. So let's take, for example, I'm going to reach out to students of Mitibai College, NM College, NMIMS College, Chennai University, Mumbai University. I can do that. If I'm going to target people who just got babies in the last 12 months, I can do that. I'm going to target people who are CEOs of companies, I can do that. So digital marketing can empower you to target whomever you want. And if you're not utilizing that, you're missing out on a very big time. Number three is measurable. Every rupee that I spend on digital, I can get statistics. I can exactly figure out that what is happening with my digital marketing. And number one, number four can give you high return. That means when I spend 1 rupee, I can actually get 4 to 5 rupees back, which is why digital marketing is the most powerful thing on this planet right now. And if you do not have digital skills, you are missing out a lot. And no matter whichever industry you go to, whether you become a CA, you become a doctor, you become a dentist, you become a botanist, no matter whatever you become, if you are not utilizing digital, you're missing out a lot in the industry. How many of you guys over here realize that right now? Type the word I do on the chat box. You need to realize this right now, that without digital, nothing can really survive. And you know why digital marketing is the most powerful thing? Because it doesn't discriminate between rich and poor. That means whether you've got 100 rupee, whether somebody's got 10,000 rupee, whether somebody's got 1 lakh rupee, they all get an opportunity to do digital marketing. And that is exactly what I mean when I say equal means equal. Digital marketing is one of the biggest equalizers. It doesn't discriminate between rich and poor. It just needs good content and good talent. And that's what I'm going to share with you guys. How can you make good content and how can you become a good talent so that you are in the world map when you start doing digital marketing for yourself? How many of you guys over here would want to utilize this power? Type the word me on the chat box in case you want to utilize this power for yourself. And today, let me tell you, we're making one of the biggest histories right now. You know why? Because there are about 75,000 people registered for the next 3 day session, out of which almost 30,000 people currently are live over here, listening to you, listening to us from worldwide. And this was a dream that I manifested at least 10 years back, that come on a global stage and address one of the largest crowds. And today, because of you guys, this dream has come true. So once again, thank you so much for coming over here. Now, there are 5 types of people in this webinar, and I wanted to classify that which type are you, because basis the way you classify it, you know, I'm going to share my content according to that. All right. The first set of people are those who have no clue what digital marketing is. You're hearing this term for the first time. That means you've heard it, but you're not really sure what it is. And you assume that digital marketing is nothing but it's only social media marketing. Type the word one on the chat box in case digital marketing is completely new for you and you have never ever done digital marketing before this. Type the word one on the chat box. All right, I can see a lot of ones coming in, right? So don't worry, even if you're starting for the first time, we got you covered, all right? The second kind of people are those people who know some basics, right? Who have done something in the past, who have done probably the unlock certification, right? But they have never implemented digital marketing. So you understand what it is, but you're not a practitioner. Type the word two on the chat box in case you've got theoretical knowledge, but you've never done it all by yourself. Type the word two. Let me see how many people over here are not practitioners. Okay, I see a lot of people. Alisha, Shivani, Rutuja, Kunal. Okay, a lot of these people. Fantastic. Number three. So don't worry. I'm going to show you in a very practical fashion today that how can you do digital marketing step by step. Are those people, you know, who just handle one aspect of digital marketing. That means you are either in social media or in SEO or in SEM. You're aware of digital, but you just specialize in one single thing in the digital marketing field. And you want to take it to the next level with that. Type the word three on the chat box in case you are somebody who's working, who's done some internship, done something over there, but just understand one aspect. It can be social media. It can be website development. It can be SEO. It can be SEM. And people are using this term for the first time. Don't worry about it. I'm going to tell you how do we do that. All right. Okay. Fantastic. Fourth is there are some people over here who have done digital marketing, who have basically also invested money into it, but you've not got results. You think that digital marketing is not for you. It's not really working out for you right now. Type the word four on the chat box in case you have done it, but you don't really believe in it. And I'm going to make in my sense, my duty to make you believe in this. Type the word four on the chat box. All right. And the last thing is, I want to understand that how many guys over here are some, there are some people over here also experts in digital marketing who make funnels, who understand the digital marketing world pretty well, you know, implementing this, but they're just here to witness one of the biggest and grandest event out here. Type the word five on the chat box. In case you're one of those people who are expert in digital, but you want to just witness this event. And I want to also understand that how many few people over here are ready to walk this journey with me from step one to step five, from becoming a novice to becoming an expert in digital marketing. Type the word, I am ready on the chat box. And we're going to kickstart that. How can you do step-by-step digital marketing for yourself. All right, so let's begin. Now, let's understand that how can you start your digital marketing journey step by step. So what I've done is I've compared the entire digital marketing with various body parts. I want to understand from you currently, which is the most important thing in your body without which no human being can survive. Put in the chat bar. Let me see that how many people over here, okay, you guys know what is the most important element in your body without which no human being can survive. So we can see heart, brain, nose. No, that's not the answer. It's not heart, it's not brain, it's not nose. Cells, not really. Okay, it's the first thing that comes in your body and the first thing that goes out from your body. What is it called? Eyes, soul, exactly. It's a soul. Soul simply, soul is the most important thing in digital. Right, sorry, most important thing in your body. And the first thing I'm going to show you, what's the soul of digital marketing? What is the first step you should do in digital marketing? The first step in digital marketing is what we call as a website. Because website is the most important thing, and maximum people today, they forget one, right? Now as a company, yes, we make, but as an individual, we do not make it. I want to understand that how many students, how many professionals, how many people out here, you have got a website with your own personal name, with your own personal name, not with the company name, with your own personal name. Type the word yes or type the word no on the chat, but let me see how many guys over here have made a website with your own personal name, yes or no. We can see a lot of no's coming in. Okay, so let me tell you that why it's so important to make a website of your own, because it's the most critical thing that you should always do. Let's understand that what it takes to make a website first. So as I told you, website is like a soul without which you cannot do digital marketing, right? So the first things first, you need a website is what we call as a domain name. Let me explain your domain in a very simple term. Let's take for example that you want to build a house. You have the land, but you want to build a house. Now, what's the first thing you do? Rather than calling a person to build a house, what do? You first name your house. You say, this house over here will be named as Ashiana. And you give the address. You basically, you know, pinpoint the location. This is where I'm going to build my house. Domain is exactly that. Domain simply is a name which you register for yourself so that the world will know you with that name. All right? Let me basically explain this to you that how does it really work. So let us first understand that basically I go to GoDaddy. Okay, so first, again, one more reminder to people. People currently who are watching us on YouTube and who are finding a lot of comments are coming in, you can just click on the cross button and you can just concentrate on the session if you like. Okay, you first go to this website called GoDaddy. And let me just take one individual out here. Okay, let me give an example from that perspective. Let's take, for example, we have got this guy called Yash Mohanani. All right, let's take me and Yash were best friends. One day, me and Yash had a very, very big fight. And I told Yash, you know what, Yash, I'm going to screw you up. And what do? I go to GoDaddy and I type over here, yashmohanani.com. When I do that, when I go to GoDaddy and I type his domain name, I might get his name over here and I can buy this name out. Now, the question is, if I find yashmohanani.com available, can I buy it? Give me a quick yes or no. Can I buy? Absolutely. I can buy it out. Correct. Now, if I buy this out, let's take for example, then Yash cannot buy this. So this is like a monopoly thing. It's like your patent or a trademark. If somebody gets it, he gets it. Then other person either has to fight the case or he has to pay money to get that thing with him. Right. So let's take about Yash Mohanani's domain name. Tomorrow, Yash goes for an interview or he goes for a business meeting or he meets some potential clients. What is the first thing the opposite person does when they go and they basically meet Yash and they want to enter into a business transaction with him or they want to give a job to him? What is the first thing anybody does when they want to hire somebody or when they want to enter into a business transaction with him or her? They research about them. Correct. Now, if they research about them, let's take, I am enemy of Yash and basically I start putting some rubbish items out there. Do you think Yash will get that job or he will crack the business deal? Give me a quick yes or no. Do you think his reputation is at a big stake? Yeah. What do you think? Yes or no? Absolutely. His reputation is a very, very big stake. Because of which, first things first, you should be doing is protect your identity. Because if you don't do that, somebody else will buy your domain name if they can do that. Now, let me tell you how big this business is of domain names. For example, a domain name called buysaladonline.com. Now, let's take a somebody wants to open a salad business. This domain is one of the premium domains. Why? It's got the exact words buysaladonline.com. And if you have such a domain, the chances of you coming on Google searches becomes very, very high, right? Can you make a guess how much would this domain name be selling on GoDaddy right now for? Put your price on the chat box. If we get yes for just $199, how much would a buy salad online be for? We have to buy something like this from GoDaddy. What do you feel? Put a number. You get 10,000, 20,000, 30,000. Okay. You want to see how much domain name is for? It's currently getting sold for 62,000 rupees. Why? It's a premium domain. Somebody has bought this and resold it back over here. You know, it's just like real estate investing. When you see real estate, how does it really work? You know, you buy real estate, correct? You keep it. When the price becomes high, you sell it off, right? It's like investments. So this is what we call this domain investing. A lot of people do that. By the way, this domain name is owned by me. All right. I own buysaladonline.com. If you see, I just bought this domain for $2,000. But today I have listed it back for 62,000 rupees on GoDaddy. Why? Because it's a premium domain name. So you can actually find such things and you can keep it with you. And if even one of this is sold, you know, you can actually make good amount of money. Let me give you an example over here. So, you know, when we were working with one of the firms, one of the biggest CEOs of this country, you know, his domain name was bought in the morning from a small child in Chennai. So somebody in Chennai bought that domain name. I don't want to name the business person out here because of confidentiality reasons, right? And that time I was handling his account. By the night, we have to get it back from him because we have to protect the businessman's identity. And when that happened, we called him up and told him that, hey, you know what? We want to understand that. Are you ready to sell this domain name? He said, how much? How much can you give me? We told him 50,000 rupees. And he said, done. We transferred 50,000 rupees to him. We got the domain name rights back. And in one day, that guy made 15,000 rupees just by becoming smart on buying and investing domain names. So technically, you should not be doing this because sometimes you can find legal trouble as well. But this is also one of the ways that actually people can make money online, you know, by finding out domain names and by investing in themselves. So how many of you people over here, you know, think this is a lucrative thing for you, right? And people actually do that. Now, let me give you one more example. So this is a website called fashionluxury.com. Do you know how many want to make a guess how much would this domain name be for? Make a guess. This domain name is still available for sales. How much was this domain name for? Put a price on the chat box. Let me see if you can get right. So you can see Aditya saying 70,000, Deep saying 3,000, Krishna saying 2 lakhs. Okay, you want to see how much is this for? Let me show you how much this is for. This domain name is currently selling for 15.9 lakhs. How many of you guys over here are shocked right now? Type the word shocked on the chat box. You're super shocked right now. This is the value of the domain name, my friends. Sometimes the domain name can be sold for very expensive price also. Correct. And I'll tell you one more example. Have you heard of aspirin tablets? Right. Can you make a guess how much is aspirin in the market sell for? Aspirin.com. Okay. This is a very famous tablet, but this domain name is still not bought. It's bought by somebody else who's listed for sale on GoDaddy. How much do you think it's for? This currently is for approximately 94 lakh rupees because aspirin is a bigger brand. So the bigger brand you become, the more you can sell your domain name for and the higher the price you can command for your domain name currently. How many guys over here are completely shocked right now, looking at domain name for 94 lakhs? So the first things first you should do, my friends, is protect yourself. Buy the domain name, protect yourself. Because if you don't protect yourself, you know, somebody else can take advantage of that for you. All right. Okay. So we cannot do apple.com random because apple.com has already been, there's a proper website on it. It's only domain names who are listed for sale. Sometimes you won't find the domain name at all. All right. This is the first step. The second step you should be doing is you should be now, let's take only by domain name doesn't need to make a website. Second thing what you need to make a website is what we call as a hosting platform. What's a hosting? Hosting technically is something like your real estate. So let's take, when I have to build a house, I need bricks. I need, you know, my cements. I need the real estate to build my home. Correct. That's your hosting. So hosting is like a Google Drive where you can put your internet files over there, and that really powers your website across the world. Okay, and that's what we call as a hosting. So you need to buy the hosting as well for you to put your website files to be available on the internet and for it to be basically be present in the World Wide Web. So we normally, what's internet? Internet is nothing but it's an interconnection of hard disks that talk to each other. So this is like a online hard disk where you can just put your files, put your folders, and you can make a website. Now, a lot of you must be thinking that, you know, currently when I have to buy my website, when I have to do a lot of these things, I need to know a bit of coding, correct? So no, you don't need to know coding. So domain name and hosting is the first two things you should buy. Type the word D and H in case you got it absolutely right. That this is the first two things you need, good domain and a good hosting, my friends. Type the word D, H on the chat box. So are we clear with the domain and the hosting concept? Yeah, I hope you're very, very clear. Now, the third thing is you need to start putting content. Now, you're not a coder, you're not a developer. How can you start putting content? How can you start making and building a site from scratch? For that, you require a content management system called WordPress. Now, WordPress is known as a blog, but it's not actually a blog. It's like a professional platform to build sites. You know what's the best part about WordPress? You need not know a single line of code to basically do WordPress. You can actually do WordPress without single coding, right? And most importantly, 65% of world's website today use WordPress, which is why you should also use WordPress as well. So let me kind of give you an example of this. Okay. For example, you can look at our own website over here, nsacademy.co. Our own website currently is built on this platform called WordPress. And it looks like a professional site without coding. Me and my team, we worked hard towards it. We made the website in approximately 10 days. Imagine. In 10 days is what you can make a website like this, correct? And it is superb because this is what a professional website looks like, and it's all built on WordPress, right? Not only my website, Aditya Birla, Facebook's, you know, a news center, MTV, TechCrunch, Your Story, Miss Malini, they all, by the way, are built on WordPress. So when you want to make a website without coding, WordPress should be your preferred choice, all right? Now, what should a website have? A website technically should be have the first thing website should have is it should pass what we call as a 10 second test. That means when you come to my site, can you tell me what my site does? My site is purely about only one thing, which is giving the people the best education possible on digital marketing. So in the first 10 seconds, people should exactly know what your website does. So remember, if your website is very confusing, people do not really know what your website actually does. There's no point building the website. Because today people don't have time. Do you agree that people are short of time today? Type the word agree in the chat box, if you agree. Because they want everything quick, they want everything fast. And if you start building a lot of time, there's no point at all. So people should be knowing exactly that, hey, this is a site, this is what it does X, Y, Z, simple. So your website should be passing the 10 second test. In the first 10 seconds, I should know exactly what it does. Second thing, your website has to be responsive. What does responsive mean? That means it should work on mobile device. When you compress it, it's tablet mode. And when I basically go to inspect over here and I just type the word mobile, okay, it basically also takes me into the mobile version of my website. So my website automatically becomes mobile friendly. It automatically becomes, you know, comes in the mobile version. And that's what really it is, my friends. Your website has to be responsive in nature, right? And the third thing you need to put relevant content. Why? Because content is something that is the most important thing. Without content, nothing can really work. So if you want, note down these steps step by step, and I'm going to show you how to do that. So just, you can see this girl telling you the steps. So note down the steps one by one. First thing first, buy a domain name. So don't waste time, buy a domain name, because tomorrow when you go for a job interview, people after 3 years are no longer going to check your CVs. They are going to simply Google search, figure out about you online, and they find something viable, they'll hire you. If they don't find, they will not hire you. And you can also showcase your talent through your website, right? Second thing is buy a hosting, because hosting is again a place where you can put your files and you can use WordPress on the hosting. So hosting is like your Windows 10, WordPress is like your Photoshop, which you install on your hosting. You start building a site on that. Then should pass a 10 second test. In first 10 seconds, person should exactly know what they're getting into. The content has to be simple. Don't use jargons. Don't use flowery language. I've seen a lot of websites using flowery language. Don't do that, right? And it should be responsive. Responsive means to work on mobile phone, tablet, computer, wherever it is. And most importantly, when you use WordPress, one of the best part about WordPress is it's got minimal maintenance cost. That means you know, you don't have to really spend a lot of money to maintain your site. All right. In fact, these are the companies who use WordPress: TechCrunch, Bloomberg, Star Wars, Facebook, PlayStation, etc., etc. Okay. Now let's take today. You want to make a website, and you think, I'm not a creative guy. I can't really make websites like that. So websites are made with this thing called themes. What are themes? Themes are like your ready-made clothes. So there are two options when you go and buy a clothing. Either you buy a ready-made cloth or you buy stitched. Which is cheaper, ready-made or stitched? It's ready-made, correct? So you go to themeforest.com. Themeforest gives you ready-made sites. It's like a Flipkart of websites. No matter whatever website you want, that you can basically use over here. Let me give you an example over here. Let's take, when I come back over here and I test type over here, let's take, I'm handling a doctor right now. I want to make a doctor website. I can just type the word doctor out here. And I can find an entire website made for doctors. Like you can see over here, Medicare, doctor, medical, healthcare. This was $69, which is approximately hardly $4,000-$5,000. When I go on live preview, I can get the ready-made site. All I need to do is copy from here, paste it on my hosting, change the content, change the image, and I can probably make a website in just one day, all right? So a lot of developers today, they don't make websites, you know, by developing from scratch. They all make website like this. You can see beautiful images, beautiful content, everything is ready-made. So just like plug and play, you take this theme, put up in your site, and your website is done. It's ready, correct? And this is how you can actually make a website from scratch. How many of you guys over here, you find this super amazing, type the word amazing on the chat box. Now this is paid, obviously. Suppose if you want to do free, there's one more option called just free themes, which you can use. Okay, so just free themes. So just free themes is like a, it's like another website where you can get only free themes. So there are a lot of free available to you as well. So you can also use this as well to actually make your website from scratch by using a lot of free themes that are available out here. All right. So these are two resources which you can use to make a website of your own. Okay, I'll give you a simple example. Now, there's a girl called Nina. She tried calling up the HR and everybody, and she was crazy behind this company called Airbnb. She said, you know what? I want to just do one job. I'm going to do a job in Airbnb. Now, when she basically did that, okay, what exactly happened? So when she did this, okay, she technically made a website. And she said, hey, I'm Nina. I'm going to work for Airbnb. Why is Airbnb almost overtaking the world? Okay. She explained why Airbnb is so important. Then she said, what's missing currently on Airbnb? Why does it matter? Where to start from? And can Airbnb move into Dubai today itself? Right. And when she did that, the Airbnb CEO was so impressed. He picked up her call and told her, you know what? I want to hire you, Nina. And he actually went and hired her. And that exactly is what I mean to say, that with websites, you can position yourself and you start branding yourself. And that, my friends, which is why I should make a website. So are you clear with the first step, people? Then why should you be making a website? And if you understood this very clearly, type the word awesome on the chat box in case you found this to be super awesome. And you think this is what exactly you needed. Type the word awesome on the chat box. So this can be the first step. Are you ready for step number two? Type the word ready in the chat box. Are you ready for step number two right now? Okay, let's go to step number two, my friends. So step number two is, let's understand that how do we start ranking on Google? So once you made a site, a good site isn't really good. Okay, when you, till time you don't rank it on top on Google searches, which is what we call this SEO. We normally call this search engine optimization. Now, what does it simply mean? Let's understand that. So when you Google search something, let's say Google search freelance designers for hire, I find two results. One is SEM, which is on top, which is called search engine marketing, where we see ads coming in. And the bottom part is called SEO. We normally call this search engine optimization, which you come on top without paying Google a single rupee. Now, you know, the reason why SEO is so important is because SEO gives you things for free. You know, like you can see this illustration out here. You know, when this guy is putting SEO, all the fishes come to him. So it really gives you a lot of traffic without paying a single rupee. And that's really the advantage of doing SEO. Now, what is SEO? Let's understand that. SEO is like a small seed. You might not come on top on Google searches immediately, but you can eventually, you will come up on top step by step if you keep on doing this consistently. right? So what's the first things first? First things first, it's free. You don't really pay a single rupee for it. Number two, it is more credible, right? So SEO technically is one of the most credible things. Why? Is because you don't come on top just like that. You come on top because of your credibility, right? Number three, okay, today people trust Google more than themselves. Do you agree with me that today people trust Google more than they trust themselves? Correct? And then if you see anyone come up online, any single person can actually come on Google searches. But the only thing he or she requires is hard work. You know why? Why hard work? Is because you need to kind of work towards it. And it's not easy to come on top. Let me tell you that it's a methodical process, step by step. And number four, you know, it basically also improves your branding. Let me now show you practically what SEO actually means. Okay, let's say go to Google right now. And let me go to Google searches. And let's take, I type over here. I'm going to search something like best romantic places. So the first step in SEO, okay, is what we call as keyword research. Why keyword? Because what do people type on Google searches is called keywords. Okay. And this is the most important thing that the person should know exactly from day number one. And you need to figure out that what are people typing on Google? Because without that, you would not be able to perform SEO. SEO simply means that you come on top for free without paying. Like for example, holidayfy.com is currently on top without paying. Now, why are they coming up on top? There's TripAdvisor, there are Make My Trip, Go IBO, there are much bigger websites than this, but why only does this website come up on top? Simply because they have done one thing is, they figure out what are people Google searching, and they put that term on their websites. You know, so I normally call SEO like a Shah Rukh Khan philosophy. You know who made Shah Rukh Khan King Khan? He himself. So, Shah Rukh Khan kept on saying, I'm King Khan, and then everybody started saying, you know, King Khan is nothing but a dish, Shah Rukh Khan. So you need to start telling Google what you want to rank on top for. Then you start coming on top. For example, why does holidayfy.com coming up on top? Number one thing, because they put this keyword, romantic places in Mumbai, in their title on the website. Then they also put this keyword over here in the URL, romantic place in Mumbai. They also put the keyword over here, romantic place in Mumbai. Like this, they have repeated the word romantic place in Mumbai at least 8 times on their website. And then Google understands, okay, this particular person wants to come on top on Google searches for this particular word. And because this content is credible, there's a lot of research, there's a lot of backend work with this. So Marine Drive, Bandra Fort, Bandra Bandstand, Mumbai, because of which they are coming up on top right now. So this is what we call is on-page SEO. There are two types of SEO. One is called on-page, one is called off-page. What is on-page SEO? On-page simply means that whatever is happening on your page. Okay, so I want to type on the chat box on-page in case you're very, very clear with this, right? On-page simply means whatever is happening on my page. And the first step is to figure out the keyword that people type on Google searches, take that keyword, put on the website in strategic places is what you should be doing, all right? Now, this is not the only factor. Let me give you an example. Let's take me and Nisha. So we got Nisha Bhagwani and we got Hitesh Motwani. We both want to become the best trainers in the industry. Nisha also says, I want to become the best trainer. I also want to say, I want to become the best trainer. And we both try to rank for this word called best motivational speaker. Let's say we both are motivational speakers and we want to rank on top for this word called motivational speaking. Now, when basically she makes a website, okay, how does she do that? So what she simply does, when she makes a website, she says, you know, disha.com, and she puts this keyword, best motivational speaker in India. I should do that, I say best motivational speaker in India. Let's say Disha puts the keyword 10 times. I put the keyword 5 times. Who ranks on top according to you? Me or Disha? Disha putting the word 10 times, I'm putting the word 5 times. Who according to you is better? Me or her? A lot of people say her. Why? Because she's got a lot of, she's repeating the word multiple times on her website. Correct? But that's not the case, my friends. Okay? Nisha doesn't just do this. Because if that was the case, somebody else can come and put 100 times and they can start ranking up on top. Correct? Which is why there's one more factor called the load speed. I mean, whose website starts loading very fast? Who repeats the keyword but also puts more content? We normally call this keyword density. That means in every 100 words, how many times do we repeat the keywords? So the Google says you cannot repeat the keyword more than twice. Let's take, for example, I wrote a 1,000 word article. I cannot repeat my keyword more than two times. Because when I do that, okay, what happens is I'm spamming Google. So Google doesn't like spamming. Then something like your website is compatible to whatever browsers, your website is also mobile friendly or not. All these factors come under on-page SEO. That's the first step of SEO. But the question is, do you think if I understand my shortfalls, I can change these things on my site? What do you feel? Yes or no? Can I change these things on my site? Absolutely. I can, right? Which is why we normally call this, okay, on-page SEO, because everything happens on my page. But it's not the only factor, my friends. Let's take, if I correct everything, and me and Nisha both are equal, that means we both actually have the same websites. We have similar websites, we've got great content, great images, great write-up, then who comes up on top? That's when the second SEO comes, which you call this off-page SEO. Let me give you an example to you. Let's take Nisha over here, his best friend is Alia Bhatt. And Alia Bhatt loves Nisha's speech. So she said, you know what, Nisha, I will write a testimonial for you on her website. She says, if you want to get motivated in life, you want to come out of depression, go to nishabhagwani.com. And this is what we call is a backlink. When one website refers to another website. But, okay, I'm more smarter than her. What do? I tell all of you guys currently, all the people out here coming out live right now, I tell all of you that, hey, you know what? Type on the chat box, Hitesh Motwani, and actually go to my website. And you should also put that Hitesh Motwani is the best trainer. And you all put Hitesh Motwani is the best trainer. Hitesh is the best trainer. Hitesh is the best trainer. What happens after that? When you put that, okay, I get about, say, 10,000 backlinks. And Nisha got one backlink. Who's better now, me or Nisha? So I got a lot of people talking about me on the internet. And they're telling me to go here, go to HiteshMotwani.com. And Nisha only gets one from Alia Bhatt. So a lot of people say me. But Nisha is still better. You know why? Because she got one backlink from a credible authority like Alia Bhatt. So it's not about the quantity of backlinks, it's about the quality of backlinks. Backlink simply means when you refer somebody to go to a site, when you share an article to go to a site, that's called backlinks. Okay? So these are two steps. This is what we call is the off-page SEO. So type down chat box off-page in case you got this absolutely right. Type the word in the chat box off-page. Okay, this is off-page SEO. So let me summarize the steps for you. First, research keywords. Number two, put the keyword in strategic places. Number three, look at technical factors like load speed, content, quality, etc., etc. Number four, get links from other websites. Start telling other people to link back to you. And number five, okay, you start getting backlinks. All right, this is your on-page and off-page SEO. On-page is what you do. Off-page is what somebody else does it for you. They start sharing your articles. Okay, same example. I've also put it over here. All right, same way. So you can see currently Tripoto, Haltify, they get a lot of third-party people talking about them. That's what we call as a backlink. So are you clear with this? Type the word clear on chat box. You're very, very clear with this so far, right? And are you guys loving this session till now? Are you getting a lot of value out here coming over here? Type the word V on the chat box, getting a lot of value, right? Because I want everyone to participate. The more you guys participate, the better you will be. You know why do I keep telling you this? Because that's where you start engaging with me, right? There's an old saying, my friends, that fingerprints are brain prints. When you start typing something, you start remembering things automatically. All right. Third step, and the most important step, is what we call is social media marketing. How many guys over here are interested in doing something on social media? Type the word me on the chat box in case you're interested in something on social media. Okay. Now, I want all of you guys to make a history with me right now. Are you ready to make a history with me right now? So I want all of you right now, currently, I want all of you guys to go to our Instagram. Go to instagram.com/NordstromAcademy. Okay, and I wanted to make this the most followed handle in just 30 seconds. The most followed handle in 30 seconds. Right, so just click on this link out here. We've got about 13,000 followers. We'll check at the end how many followers we've grown. All right, after 1 or 2 minutes. But I wanted to go over here, click on the follow button, right? Because we're going to share you some interesting content. Let me tell you explain to you different types of social media in a very simple fashion. So the one thing on social media is to write great content. Because if you do not write great content, okay, that's where things can actually fail. So we put the link of Instagram handle on your chat box, click and follow. All right. And you also get the recording of today's session on Instagram, recording of today's session on YouTube. So in case you're watching us right now, okay, click on subscribe, okay, and wait for the recording to come tonight. All right, because you're going to get the recording session also. So let me explain to you different types of social media with the help of a donut. All right. So if you see Instagram, Instagram is all about visual medium. It's all about classic photography. So when you click it, when you just click a donut, you won't just take a donut picture. You basically put your arm swag, put some designer clothes at the background, click a nice picture and say, I'm having classic donut right now. That's Instagram. It's flashy, it's punchy, it's lifestyle based. Number two, it's Facebook. So on Facebook, what do? You just say, I like a donut. You know why? For example, all of you might be having at least 400, 500, 1,000 friends on Facebook right now. But the question is, how many people do you see on your timeline when you start surfing Facebook? Hardly any 400 to 500 people. Okay. When you do that, so you only see about 4 to 5 people or next 15 people only on Facebook. So the thing is, why doesn't Facebook show you all the content? It's because Facebook does not want to show you all the content. They only want to show you content that you love. All right. So I've seen a lot of brands, a lot of companies, they start doing social media for a brand. What do? We just start copy pasting content. We just copy content from one place and we start copy pasting content at multiple places. Do you think it's the right thing to do or wrong thing to do? Type the word right or wrong. What do you feel? Right thing to do or wrong thing to do? It's not the right thing at all, right? It's the wrong thing. Why? Because today people need customized content. On Instagram, we need the content to be very pictorial friendly. We need it to be flashy, nice, classy. But on Facebook, we want the content to be engaging. For example, if I put the same photograph on Facebook, I'll say, how many of you guys over here love donuts and what type of donut you love? And I'll ask people to comment over there. So in case you're on Instagram right now and you're listening to me in the background, I want you to go to Instagram right now. I'm going to type which type of donut you love on Facebook. You like double chocolate? You like chocolate? You like double trouble? What do you like? Right? Because that's Facebook. That's Instagram. It's about engagement. You have to build engagement over there. Right? Number three, okay, is YouTube. So YouTube is all about visual medium. I can now eat donuts in two fashion. I can either be very groggy. I can either be very sophisticated in front of you and I eat donut with a fork and a knife. But I can eat donut with just taking donut over here and I can just shove it in my mouth and I just enjoy my donut. Right? That's YouTube. So I say, this is how I eat my donut and probably my video will start going viral. Correct? TikTok, okay, is where I do a donut dance. And I take my donut, I dance and I make it a trend. I make it a challenge. And I say, you know what? I challenge all of you to do the same donut, right? And on LinkedIn, I talk about my skill set. So I'll say, you know what? I currently can eat 50 donuts in 1 hour. That's how you put on LinkedIn. So LinkedIn is more about professional content. In Pinterest, it's actually about, you know, I taking donut and I putting the recipe of donut in a pictorial format, right? And this, if you see, my friends, the same content, I'm making it personalized to different social media handles, correct? And that's the mistake maximum people make. They take the same content and they just paste it on different channels. If you're an individual, it's okay, but if you are handling a brand, you cannot make this mistake. Let me summarize things for you. So if all social media platforms had to be like a donut, Instagram would be more pictorial. It would be having classic filter. It would be more, you know, user-friendly. But on Facebook, I want to engage people. I'll ask people a question. I'll take responses from people because the more response I get, more my content starts going up on top. YouTube is all about visual expressions. I do something funny. I do something interesting. So people come on YouTube and they start doing things. TikTok is about me having a challenge, having a trend. LinkedIn is all about professionalism. I can't be funny out, but I have to be professional enough to show my skill set because there are recruiters watching me out there. Pinterest. It's all about having recipes and videos and content in an infographical format. So I can actually put infographics and put it over there. And that, my friends, is social media for you right now, right? Did you guys enjoy this example? Type the word loved it in the chat box if you love this example. So if you see, in just a matter of 1 minute, we crossed about 14.8K. We just crossed about more than 3,000 followers right now in just a matter of small time. Right? And that's the kind of content. This is what we call as content marketing, my friends. You need to put great content out there on the platform, right? So in case you're still watching me, you haven't followed currently, you're so busy engrossing, you know, looking at my content, press the follow button, my friends. That's what it is. All right, let's go forward right now. right? So social media essentially is you have to be driven by having great content. All right. So there are three aspects of social media. The first aspect is what we call is making great creatives. You know, how did we make the creative? We made the creative through an online platform called Canva. It's a beautiful tool, absolutely freely available. You can use Canva to make your creatives. And you need not be a designer, need not be somebody who is professional with it. And it's not about a software, it's about your visualization. How do you visualize the content? So social media, I give you a small tip. Make your content minimalistic. Have more white spaces and put your content or the text straight away in the middle. Your content will stand out. Okay. The second thing is what you write on social media. Writing is also an art. Not everybody can write. So try to make your content more engaging. Ask people to talk to you. Okay. So creative plus content is what is equal to good and successful social media campaign. So remember the formula, guys. The formula is what we call is CCS. You need to have fantastic creatives. You need to have fantastic content. That's when you get success. So I want to type in the chat box, CCS on the chat box. Okay. CCS. All right. So, it's not that difficult to make such things as I told you. So I can just go to this website called Canva and I can actually make a fantastic, a lot of you must be knowing this website already, right? But one thing which has come new on Canva right now is what we call this animated designs. So nowadays, in fact, if you want to make a PowerPoint, if you start want to make social media posts, they also have a lot of animations out here. You can see animated social media posts. They can actually do that. They can actually use animations because that's what grabs attention nowadays. It grabs people's retention ratio, right? And you can actually start making content out there from scratch. Even if you're not a designer, you've never done this in the past, you can still do it. Okay, so let's take, for example, I can just take this small content and I can say over here something like, we are making history. And I can just reduce this font size a bit to 25. I can also make this 25. So you can just take any content, just use the way it is, right? So don't really change the aesthetic of design because design is something which is already pre-made. You can see the animation coming. Let's take on my own picture. I can just click on upload. I can upload my own picture over here. And I can simply take a photograph, upload live over here, and I can just do this. It's so quick, so fast. And it's animated, it grabs attention. I can start putting my social media platforms and I can start doing this. Okay, and let's take on add my own text. Let's take on give a thank you to all of you. I can just click a small text. Come over and you can just say thank you. Right, and that is, I can change the color over here to black. That's it, my friends. Very quick. So how many guys over here think that you'll be able to make creatives? People who are doing it for the first time have no idea how to make creatives. How many guys over here think that this is super helpful for you? And download the media into MP4 format because Instagram doesn't support GIFs. You start making content out there. So you can make a lot of content from this one tool itself. It's a lifesaver for most of you. And just in case you want some free pictures, you can go to the website called freepic.com. Okay. So freepic is basically a website where you can get good pictures and good vectors. Let's take one donut vector out. I can just type donut. I can just type the word vector. I can just press enter. And I can get a lot of free vectors out here. Vectors and animation images, which you just saw. Okay, and I actually use this for myself. So you can see over here, we get a lot of these vectors, which are absolutely free. We can take this from here and we can put up a social media handle for ourselves, right? So all these pictures are royalty free. You can actually use these pictures to build a brand for yourself and start doing things. So freepic.com is a website, my friends, from where you can actually start making, you can get images for absolutely free and you can start using social media. So you don't have to pay for images, and content writing is an art. Where basically you just try to understand people's problem and you start figuring out their content. So if you want to be successful on social media, you need to have a content strategy, what we call as a content calendar. I see a lot of people, when they start making content, they just start making content of their gut when they just wake up every morning. So don't do that. You need to figure out, okay. So you need to first make a list of content that you can write. For example, I've got a list for all of you. In case you want this list, click a snapshot, click a picture of this and keep it handy with you. Now, what kind of content can you post on social media? You can post quotes, memes, tips, tutorials. Let's take a fashion beauty salon. I can say quotes by famous designers. I can have some quick memes. Meme when I do my nail polish, or meme when I do my manicure or pedicure, right? I can give a quick tip on how can you do makeup and styling at your home. I can give some tutorials. How can you do stuff with your home stuff and you can start looking good for your skin or whatever it is. I can do some question answers live with people. Right? So you pick up your finger, put in any content and you make your content that way. So you can see every Monday I'm going to put memes, every Tuesday I'm going to put course, every Wednesday I'm going to put XYZ stuff. When you start doing that, you start making what we call the content calendar. Now, in case if you're wondering, how do I automate my content? You can actually automate your content as well. So you don't have to like post every single day. You can just be there on one Sunday, take the content, all right, write down all the content and make all the creatives from Canva and your content at one go, then automate with a software called Buffer. Buffer.com is a free tool from where you can automate your content. So you can just upload content for across all the channels on Facebook, on Twitter, you know, on Instagram, everywhere by doing this, right? So I wanted to again make a history. Are you ready to make a history with me? Type the word ready on the chat box. Are you ready to make a history with me right now? So what I want you guys to do right now is pretty simple. I want all of you people, okay, to actually just come over here, and I wanted to basically click a picture of this tool right now. Click a picture of this image, which is in front of the screen right now. And I want you to just take a screenshot of this. And I want to put it on Twitter right now with the hashtag NSABDC, Nordstrom Academy Biggest Digital Conference. So I want to put in the chat box for all of you. Okay. I want to basically take this picture, post it on Instagram, post it everywhere, post it on Twitter, and I want you to tag us @ Nordstrom Academy. Tag us so that we can know what you guys are doing right now. So no matter which way, use whatever platform you have, Facebook, Twitter, whichever you want. All right. That's social media, my friends. Let me give you an example of how one girl got a job in social media. So there's this girl called Ankita Chawla. She actually made what we call the Instagram CV. So she actually did this. You know, she went to Instagram, and rather than putting up profiles and selfies, she actually put her own CV, and she made the world's first Instagram CV. Now, when she did that, what typically happened from her is, you know, the CV went viral on the internet, and she got a job at Deloitte. So, you know, you can actually use social media for creative ways. You can actually get a job on social media as well just by doing this. And this is the first three steps when you do. Make a website, understand how to rank a website, understand how to do social media marketing. So are we clear so far? Type the word clear on chat box. I think they're very, very clear with this. All right, let's go to the next step. Let's go to the fourth step, the fourth thing that we need. So you can see this website is like your soul. SEO is like your mouth. Social media is like your basically, you know, like the way you start doing transactions. The fourth step is what we call as analytics. Let me explain you how analytics really work. Okay. So there's a free platform for analytics called Google Analytics. So you can just go to this website called analytics.google.com. It's a completely free website. You have to integrate analytics to your website. Okay. Once you do that, our website might literally crash right now, but I'm still going to try this out because I want to show you some real life demo from which you'll be able to figure out that this is what is magic. Yeah, so just think you start doing social media, start putting efforts on how to rank your site on Google searches. If you don't look at the data, how will you find out about yourself? So I want all of you guys currently to go to our site. Called nsacademy.co. I want all of you guys to go to the site called nsacademy.co. It's in front of the screen right now. Just go to Google right now, or go to Google, type on Google Nordstrom Academy Digital Marketing. Just type on Google Nordstrom Academy Digital Marketing course. Just type about Nordstrom Academy only. That's absolutely fine. Go to Google, type the word Nordstrom Academy, and you'll find the first website, nsacademy.co. Go over there right now. So you can see over here, when I go to my real time, I can check there are about 25 people have joined in right now. There are more people joining in currently, right? So this is the amount of people that are coming to our website. I have literally crashed right now. It's okay. You see the numbers going crazy, right? There are 87 people on my homepage, 3 people on the digital marketing course page, 2 people on the about us page. I can see in real time what's happening on my site right now. When I go to locations, I can figure out what location you're from. So if you're not gone, don't go right now. Just come over here and see this. You can see currently maximum from India, then UAE, then US. From India, I want to figure out where you guys come from. So from India, you can see people come from Mumbai, Pune, Chennai, Navi Mumbai, Hyderabad, Thane, Coimbatore, We can see, how did you come to our site? Did you come by Google? Did you come directly? Let's understand that. So we can see that maximum people were 299 people, over 135 plus people over here came directly. 85 people came through Google, 70 people came through YouTube, and 1% came through many link over here, right? And let's look at the content. So currently, what are you watching? So when you start shuffling pages, we can figure out where you are. So 360 people currently are there on our homepage, 7 people on my digital marketing course page, 3 people on my contact us page, and 2 people on my search engine optimization page. And that's what we call as analytics, my friend. How many guys over here find this super amazing? You found this absolutely wow. Type the word wow on the chat box. And if you found this, wow. And that is analytics, my friend. We can actually figure out where do people come from, what marketing is working for you, how it is working for you. Okay, I can't believe you can see the numbers just shooting up. We got 500 people right now. So I would just request not to go there because the website literally crashed at this point in time, right? And this is fine. This, my friend, is what we call is analytics. That's a fourth step. Let's summarize. What is the first step in digital marketing? Everybody, website. Second step in digital marketing, SEO, ranking on site. So first I make a site, I did rank on top. Then third step, I start doing social media for it. I start posting out content, making content calendar. Then fourth step, I integrate analytics and I check what's happening. Where are people coming from? I can see the data, correct? So now we are almost 80% through. Let's look at the fifth step. Okay, the fifth step is what we call is branding. So we need to start branding ourselves. And what's branding? Let me explain branding to you. Okay. If you don't have a site, you can work with LinkedIn. Because LinkedIn is the first thing people check about you when you go online. And you need to brand yourself. You need to really position yourself as expert. So people over here, you know, who haven't been, you know, want to take, stay in touch with me, follow me, put some inquiries, go to my LinkedIn right now, and you can actually add me on LinkedIn. Okay, you can just type on the LinkedIn Hitesh Motwani and you can add me over there. You can also follow me on Instagram called Hitesh Motwani. And also what you can simply do is you can actually go and you can start positioning yourself very well on LinkedIn. So branding is how do you maintain consistency? For example, you see everywhere, wherever I go, I position myself as a digital marketing trainer, expert and a speaker. Okay, that's my branding. So that's my consistent line, which I maintain everywhere, right? For example, which is this brand over in front of you? This brand is, what is this brand called? This brand is called Cafe Coffee Day, correct? Now, what is Cafe Coffee Day? Cafe Coffee Day is basically, what is the specialty with Cafe Coffee Day? No matter whichever Cafe Coffee Day you go to Coimbatore, Chennai, Kolkata, Bangalore, Mumbai, all the Cafe Coffee Days look the same, correct? That's what I mean branding. So what I mean, let me give you an example. Who's this guy in front of you? Put in the chat box if you know him. His name is Robin Sharma, very famous guy, correct? So Robin Sharma, what's his color scheme of his site? His color scheme is purple, black, and white. So branding simply means you need to be consistent with yourself. For example, what's our color scheme in Nordstrom Academy? Our color scheme is purple, black, and white, and yellow to some extent. It's basically purple and yellow currently. So when I go to my Instagram, you look at all our posts. What color are they? They are normally yellow and purple. All of them are tinge of yellow and purple. Correct? Why? Is because that's our brand color, that's branding. So we need to make it consistent. You need to have a similar look and feel. Because if you do not really keep similar look and feels for your brand, people would not know you. People would not remember you in this case. You can see all the creatives is purple or tinge of purples and it's yellow and purple everywhere. That's branding, correct? So look at Robin Sharma. His color scheme is purple, black and white. Look at his creatives, all purple and black and white. Look at his YouTube channel, black and white, black and white, black and white. That's branding. So remember guys, branding means what? Branding means consistency. So I wanted to type in the chat box, consistent. Type the word C in the chat box. So I wanted to put this in the brain that you need to be consistent with your efforts. You need to be consistent with whatever you do. Because consistency is the key, my friends. All right, that's branding. And the last step in digital, okay, is when we start doing paid campaigns. Remember guys, when you don't pay, nothing can really work. Right? Even when you plant a seed, you need to pay it with water every day. Correct? If you want to grow fast, if you really want to go to the level 10 of marketing, you need to know paid marketing. Because today, brands, companies, they all want to pay to reach out to people and know exactly what people do. If you do not pay, you do not really go out there and start doing paid campaign. How do you reach out to new people? Correct? That's paid campaign. So let me tell you about this. So basically this is like, now what is this? We also call this SEM. We normally call this search engine marketing. What search engine marketing? When you Google search, you start seeing ads coming up on top. As I told you, SEO is time consuming. It will take at least 6 months to 1 year to come on top on Google searches. If you want to come up on top very fast, you need to pay for the keyword, right? So we normally call this Google Ads. So if you just type on the Google things, say thing called CRM software, you find ads coming on top for Zoho, GetApp, and Demo, and GetDemo, right? Now when I click on Zoho's website and I go to Zoho's website, okay, that is where he gets paid traffic, and he has to pay per click. That means when I click on that particular ad, he has to pay 1 or 2 rupees. By the way, I want to take the opportunity to even thank Zoho to be our email partner. So all the emails that are coming to you are in the partnership with Zoho right now, right? Now, why do you need to go to paid marketing? You need to do paid marketing simply because, you know, when you start doing paid marketing, that will help you to get more sales, get you more leads. How many guys over here want more sales? Type the word I want on the chat box. In case you want to get more sales. You'll only get sales if your message is reaching out to the right people. Like suppose I'm a guitar manufacturer. Somebody searches acoustic guitar. If I show him acoustic guitar and I show him good value, why won't he buy from me? Right? Now, what I've seen is one of the biggest mistakes that people make when they start doing sales, okay, is they just keep on pushing the product. They just keep on selling their products, right? But remember, people don't buy product. People buy results. When I buy a guitar, I buy it with an intention of being a good guitar. When I basically buy a weight loss plan, I do it with the intention of losing weight. Do you agree with me? People buy results. People do not buy products or services. Give me a quick yes on chat box. And do you agree with me? So we want people to buy results. We do not want people to just buy things over there, right? So when you start putting paid campaigns, think about a solution and not the product, right? Because solution is everything. Now, I'm going to do a small exercise with you. After this exercise, you'll be able to understand your target audience. You'll be able to understand what to write on your ad campaign. Let's say we do a Facebook ad campaign. This is a typical Facebook ad campaign. So one of this girl called Kavita Singh, she's trying to basically, you know, sell her weight loss program. So she just simply puts over here, lose weight in 1 month up to 6 kgs. Want to know how? Click here. How many guys over here who are looking to lose weight will click on this ad? Give me a yes or give me a no. First of all, do you think this ad is very good or do you think the ad is very bad? I think that is very okay. It's not that great. Let's make an ad better. So how do you do that? First thing what you surely should be doing is you should be figuring out what are people's problem. So first thing first, figure out what problem is Kavita facing, or when you realize that people actually become fatter, right? Let's understand that first. So can you put in the chat box that what are the instances where people actually, when they realize they're becoming fat? Some instances are when people actually, you know, don't fit back in your old clothes. That's the first thing, right? So that's when you realize, okay, I'm getting fatter. Number two, when everyone else starts calling you fat, correct? Because if you say you're becoming fat. By the way, how many guys are going through this situation right now? People are telling you that you're becoming fatter and fatter sitting at home, right? Third thing is when you become a bit lethargic and you're a bit low on energy right now, right? And most importantly, sometimes health issues start coming in. Do you agree all of these are problems for people? This is what people face. So when they're looking for a weight loss plan, they don't want to lose weight. They want to get rid of these problems. So when you start positioning your ad campaign, don't just say, okay, this is my ad, this is my creative, buy my product. Don't do that. Start positioning yourself by actually solving these problems. I'll just flip the around. So first step, write down problems. Second step, write down the solution to these problems. So that's what I write over here. I say, do you wish to fit back in your old clothes? Do you wish to be healthy and fit? Do you wish to get people to notice you? If your answer to the above is yes, then we've got results for you. We'll help you to lose weight without giving up your favorite food. If you want to know more, click here. How many of you guys over here feel which copy is better? The first one where I just say lose weight in 1 month or 6 kgs, want to know how? Click here. Or this one where I say, do you wish to fit back in your old clothes? Let me tell you how to do that. Which one will you click on? The first one or second one? So if you want to see results, why are you not getting results from your ad? You know why? Because you're just shoving information on people's face. You're not giving them value. Value is the keyword, my friends. If you start solving people's problem, people will 110% buy from you. And that is what it is, my friends. You need to ensure that people buy from you because of your product and services giving a result, not just because you got a product. And that's what differentiates market leaders and somebody who's just a small startup, is because you start differentiating yourself. For example, like, what is our differentiation? We normally give practical oriented programs. We do not just give information. We actually bring transformation in people's life. And this, my friends, is digital marketing. Let me give you an example of how one guy got a job with running Google Ads. So again, for students out here, there was a guy called Alec Brownstein. He wanted a job in his company called Creative Land Asia. Now what he did, you know, he just Google searched. Okay, he just started, you know, giving Google Ads on this. So when he gave a Google ad, he ran a Google ad on the CEO's name. So when the CEO Googled his own name, he said, Ian Reachel. And then this ad came up on top on Google ad, which said, hey, Ian Reachel, Googling yourself is a lot of fun. Hiring me is fun too. And when they clicked, he saw his CV and he got a job. How many of you currently find this to be very creative? Type the word awesome on the chat box in case you found this super awesome, right? So you don't need Naukri.com. You don't need a third party portal to get your job. You need to be smart to get your job. You just need to find out the right audience, figure out who needs a product or service, who needs you, you know, show him at the right time, at the right place, and you'll get your job, my friends. You'll get your career, you'll make your career. And this is basically, you know, what I call is digital marketing. It's exactly this. Let's do a quick recap now. Are you ready for a recap, my friends? What is the first step in digital marketing? First step is to make a website, buy a domain, buy a hosting, use WordPress to make a site. Number two is to do your branding and content, do social media content, right? Because content is very, very important. Start doing social media marketing, start putting out content. So number two is actually SEO, then it is your social media and content. My bad of the orders, right? So you need to start, then you start doing SEO, you start ranking your site on top on Google searches, step by step by step by step. Then start doing social media. We need to start performing social media marketing, start making content calendars, start automating your content, make creatives, do your stuff, right? Then next, look at branding. And after that, look at analytics, look at data, because data is everything. Without data, you can't do anything. Look at data. Look how do people come, where do people come from? And last things last, do paid campaigns. If you do these six things, my friends, you become an expert in digital marketing. There are more things in digital, like email marketing, influencer marketing, affiliate marketing. Just to give you perspective, affiliate marketing is, it's basically when you start referring somebody else's product and they pay you a commission for it. For example, I refer Amazon's product, I give my link of Amazon, you click on that link, you go and purchase the product and you get a commission on that. That's called affiliate marketing. But if you understand these six things, you have basically understood basics of digital marketing now, and then you need to start implementing these things in depth to become a full-fledged, a full-stack marketer. So after this, how many guys over here are motivated to actually become a digital marketer? Type the word I am on the chat box and be motivated to become a digital marketer, because every single thing which I spoke about is going to help you to get a job, do a business, get sales, and become famous. You don't become famous just like that. You have to do all of these things to become famous, my friend. Step by step by step by step, or you become a specialist in just one thing over here. Right? And this is exactly how you start doing digital. So I'm just going to take a few more moments, my friends. Okay, if you don't mind, I know it's already 6:30. All right. But I request more 15 minutes from you to tell you more about, you know, some very valuable stuff. Do I have a permission? Type the word, I am ready on the chat box. You're ready to stay here for a bit more longer time with me. Right. So people have got commitments. If you want, you can leave, but I would request you to stay back because we're going to have your test also after in this short while. Okay. Great. Now, if you see, you know, it's very, very important that you start your learning curve, you start your learning journey. You see, there are these two kinds of people. One is basically the regular person, you know, who lives a life the ordinary way. But the second kind of person is that who is a lifelong learner, who is committed to learn. And I'm so proud that approximately 25,000 people currently over here are lifelong learners. You know why? Because you, first of all, you showed your first commitment by coming over here and staying over here till the entire session. So first of all, I'd like to congratulate all of you that you're a part of this journey with me. And just pat your back and just say congratulations. Now, you see, there are two kinds of people in this world. One, the regular person, with the lifelong learner. You see, maximum of us, what we think that I'll finish my college, I'll finish my education, and that's it. You know, after that, I'll figure out what to do, what not to do. But the problem is your college education, your school education, nothing offensive over there, but they do not really teach you how to survive in the real world. Do you agree with me? They help you to get a job, but they don't really help you to negotiate with clients. They don't really help you to get more money from the clients. They don't teach you the art of getting sales done for yourself. If you agree, type the word yes on the chat box. So people who got time, people who are, you know, who my Muslim friends, you know, who want to break the fast, you can leave, no problem on that. And you can catch the recording of the session when you put up in a, put up in the night for you guys. All right. So now what a regular person does, you know, he does the same thing again and again. So he has this routine of life. He just comes, wakes up in the morning without any aim, watches television, does some basic work, helps his parents, but his life is just going on very plain and simple mode. He probably get a job. But a lifelong learner, what he does, he seeks mentorship. He learns from expert. He learns from everybody. Like, you know what? How did I change my industry after so many years? Because I was a learner. I went to every single mentor to asking them to make me learn, because learning should never stop. Even today, I invest at least 4 to 5 hours in my learning, even now. Most importantly, if you see, you know, also we form this trap of what we call as unstructured learning. Okay, what's unstructured learning? Essentially, unstructured learning is where we look at sporadic content, but if you see the content is not in a particular order. Like, I'm sure that you must have heard hundreds of digital marketing sessions before this. But digital marketing sessions essentially are very basic, you know, they're very unstructured and they just keep on telling things in a very boring fashion. But if you have a structured learning approach, that means if you get a learning step by step, just like, you know, when you climb a ladder, right? You, this can actually help you to grow your business and have clarity in your mind, because sometimes you're not clear in your mind, you would not know how to do things. Which is why, if you really want to commit yourself to being a lifelong learner, you need to find somebody who's walked your path, learn from somebody's experience, learn from somebody's failure, because that is what can help you to become a lifelong learner, my friends. So I want to understand, and I want to actually check, you know, how many guys over here are lifelong learners? Type the word LLL, lifelong learner. Okay. So, you know, which is why I want to give you a gift today. And the gift is that I want all of you to today put up on your social media handles, and I want all of you guys to actually invite more and more people tomorrow. Because tomorrow I'm going to show you how can you become an influencer in just next 30 days. And I want one more thing from all of you. I want all of you to currently share this message with your other friends to be there tomorrow, because the next 3 days we want to break all the records which are possible. So I want you to currently click a picture of this, click a picture of this certificate, Nordstrom Academy, click a picture of this and say, this is certified that I, you put a blank space over there. I want you to put your name, click a picture, put your name. So I'll just say, I'm Tanya Pavani, Nandan Kumar, Jyoti Kanse, Krishna Kumar, whatever it is. And I was a part of India's largest digital marketing seminar on 8th May. Can you do that? Tap the word, I am doing it right now. I want to click a picture, take a screenshot, put it up on your Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, whatever you use, send it to your friends. And I want you to make a history with me. Okay. And put your name over here, share it with your friends and tell them to come tomorrow. Because tomorrow the learning should never stop. Okay. So I'll hold on for a moment over here. Hold on for a moment for you guys to do this. All right. I hope everybody see the picture over here. Let's move forward then. All right. And I want you to do one more favor to me. I want you to click a picture of this, share it with your friends, family, whoever it is, and tell them to come for the next 2 days. Because next 2 days, I'm going to show you, tomorrow I'm going to show you how can you become an influencer, the top 1% in your industry. And even if nobody knows you, people will start knowing you in the next 30 days. That's my challenge to all of you. So I want to understand how many of you guys over here are committed to become an influencer. Tap the word I, commit. Okay, type the word I, commit. And I wanted to share this with every single person in your college, in your family, your father, mother, parents, colleagues, watchmen, because they all deserve a chance to go digital, my friends. The entire India deserves a chance to go digital. And we can only go digital with your help. It is you who are digital.